Brooke, we do not, look, they're still standing. We do not get this very often on this show, so clearly a testament to who you are. Aww. Welcome back to the show, first of all.
Thank you so much.
The last time we talked to you and your last album was Emotion, mm-hmm. and now you are back with Dedicated, which released earlier this year, as Cynthia had mentioned. And we read somewhere that the original working title for this album was Music to Clean Your House To. So tell us that story, and what was the sound you wanted to explore?
It was more of a joke working title than a real working title. But yes, I was sending out, I had made so many songs for this album that I kind of was getting advice from friends and bandmates. So I was sending them sort of like folders to listen through, and I would only listen back to my own music when I was cleaning, because I was nervous, so I had to like do something. So the joke title was Music to Clean Your House To.
Nice.
Take a listen, let me know your votes.
So, Carly, there are 15 tracks on this album, but as I understand it, it didn't start out that way. You wrote a lot, like 200 songs.
Yeah.
So how did you whittle the list down?
I went a little insane. No, I kind of get like stuck in these creative little hamster wheel like roots. Then 4 years later, I come out of it and I'm like, someone tell me to stop. but it's always been my process since the beginning, even with like Tug of War. I looked down at my dad's studio and I had like so many song ideas before I selected the one. So I would love if I just wrote like the 15 songs and called it a day, but I'm a bit of a perfectionist, so I write a ton before I find what I land on. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You were also going through a breakup, right, yeah. while you were writing this album, and that can tend to like feed into, I'm sure, the creative.
Gotta try it from all different
right?
angles.
Yeah. But you wrote this song called Party for One, and I just want to talk about like the significance of the meaning behind that song.
Yeah, I actually, I'm really good friends with my ex, so we were in Sweden, and it's kind of coming to the end of the relationship, and I was in the hotel by myself, and I was waiting for wine glasses to be sent up, and I was like, party for one! And I can remember, I was like, that's gonna be the song I work on tomorrow. So I got to kind of like work it out with some Swedes and producers who I became good friends with, and he laughs now every time he hears that song. Hey, you inspired it. Thank you.
Earlier this year, GQ called you the people's pop star. And it's because you appeal to young and mature, he, she, they, people who are gay, straight, fluid, everybody. What does it mean to you to have such a diverse fan base? And what do you think it is about your writing that connects to everybody?
Oh, I don't know. I mean, I write about love a lot, and I think that is a really universal kind of connection in that. I think it can feel like what we're experiencing or what I'm experiencing is solely my experience, but it's not. It's a story that everyone's gone through, heartbreak and hopefulness and, like, the beginnings of something. Mm-hmm. I don't know. I will say that I'm very lucky when I get to go out into the room of a show and kind of see the widespread sea of people. It always kind of... It never ceases to amaze me, and I always feel like, all right, we're gonna party this thing together, and the room feels really lovely, so, yeah.
You're one of our favorite Canadian fashion icons. We've seen you in so many different looks, both on this show and out in the world. You love changing it up, so how does style empower you?
Well, mostly I don't love being recognized, so I keep changing my hair color. Also, it's like girls just want to have fun. Cyndi Lauper, change it up, try on all the different things. I've kind of grown more comfortable with the fact that I don't have one set rule for fashion. I really just like to play.
We get feedback all the time. People are like, I hate what you're wearing. Do you like your fans like comment in on and influence you?
Yeah, I mean, this is a sort of a funny story, but my grandmother is doing okay right now, but she was sick a little bit earlier, and I went to visit her in the hospital, and she's like, Carly, one last thing. And I was like, this is gonna be some like words of wisdom. I can't wait. I'm like, yes, grandma. She's like, you should never wear those shorts again that you wore. Okay.
Oh my God.
Good to know.
Love that story.
Grandma's keeping it honest.
Always. Grandma's always keeping it real.
Yeah.
Great to see you. Thank you so much for being here. Tour tonight in Hamilton and tomorrow night right here in Toronto. We're back right after this.